So one of the cool things with this is when I grew up and all of us grew up, it was the battering ram dinosaur. Because you can, that skull is up to 10 inches thick. Pachy means thick, cephalo means head, saurus means lizard. And this particular animal, it maybe got 12, 13 feet long, 1,100 pounds on the high side. It's got legs that are designed to run, claws could help grip the ground. Plant eater, even though it's got those sharp fang looking things up front, it's herbivorous. Could have eaten some lizards or what have you. So crashing heads. So a study came out a few years back, I want to say it was 2 years ago now, where they started looking, because there's always been some argument. Why would you, if you're going to be a battering ram, they've got those wide horns up on the hind legs. I got pictures of them crashing into each other. It's pretty exciting, pretty loud. That's a dome. If you're going to crash, you're going to slide by one another. And you're not going to necessarily, like, football helmets are designed when you crash to slide. But, all right, let's take account of all the pachycephalosaur skulls and all of the animals that are called pachycephalosaurs. So Draco Rex, Homocephaly, Goiocephaly, Stygimoloch. They took all of these into a growth series, and they started noticing some interesting things, such as the injuries on the pachycephalosaurus skulls were usually on the sides and were more reminiscent. The hypothesis is they would shoulder up next to each other, and like giraffes do, take their neck and thwack it. So if you've got this big solid skull and you've got a strong neck and huge power
not much
in your hips,
things.
You could crash your head into the hips of your opponent to try to be the kingpin. Now, how do we? Well, we assume it's a male, but that's because males in every species seem to tend to be violent, warlike, crazy creatures.
Hard-headed.
Yeah, hard-headed, but on bump. Whereas the kind, logical, sensible women aren't going to go up and say, "You know what? Smack." Whereas the first thing I look at Billy, South Park. Whoa. So as a result, what happens is the original thought of crashing heads has been set aside by. The most recent information suggesting they bash side to side.
When you say most recent, what's most recent?
2 years ago.
Oh, wow.
So another interesting piece of this is the small skulls and the skulls with lots of spikes, because they make way spikier versions, they didn't have the injuries on the sides of the heads. So the thought is only the big domed ones with that big dome in the center. So the hypothesis is they start out spiky, and then, because that keeps you safer a little bit if you got to run and stab somebody, and as they get older, the bone does something that almost never happens. It gets reabsorbed and added to pile on the dome to give you this big, thick, 10-inch thick skull. And if you've got a big 10-inch thick skull crashing into something, that's going to cause a lot of pain, havoc, and trauma, and they do see some injuries. They did some 3D modeling to determine that, yeah, you could have survived.